Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that, artistic friends. That's why you have artistic friends. Welcome to DevSpeed. Today we're doing a DPS fluid change on a 2004 CRV. Well, it's a daily driver of our fellow drifter, Walker. It's got 318,000 miles and he's done the rear differential fluid in the past. He doesn't remember when he did it, so we're gonna do it again today. Let's check it out. We're gonna run through a Honda dual pump fluid change and talk a little bit about Honda's dual pump system. Here we have a Honda CRV 2004, and it's one of the vehicles made by Honda with a DPS, which are exclusively in Honda and Acura vehicles with all-wheel drive. DPS is Honda's proprietary dual pump system, right? So one for the front wheels and one for the back. It provides traction by sending more power to the back wheels if the front starts slipping. And why is it used? Well, it weighs less than conventional four-wheel drive systems, improves fuel economy, and requires less maintenance. A little bit about DPS fluid, right? So DPS fluid is required on more than 4 million Honda and Acura all-wheel drive vehicles. It lubricates the moving parts, it controls the hydraulic system, and transmits engine torque to the back when needed. It protects parts against wear, and it removes heat from internal parts. So the dual pump system requires little maintenance, just a periodical fluid change to keep the system running smoothly. The recommended service interval is 30,000 miles, and it takes about 1.1 quarts on a drain and fill, and 1.3 if you've refurbished the differential. Some places you'll see that it says 1.6, but realistically, there's the fill line. So as long as it's not coming out of the fill plug, you're good, it's full. So ENEOS provides the only OE replacement fluid available. ENEOS Import DPS Fluid. A trusted supplier of OE factory fluids, count on ENEOS to provide the same quality, expertise, and specifications as the manufacturer. Now, how do we change the fluid? It's a pretty simple drain and fill. So here we have the rear differential, and we're gonna have Dustin help us change this fluid.
Ready.
All right, let's do this. We're always gonna open which plug first?
Top one.
The fill plug always gets open first, and that's for, well, if you can't get fluid back into it. So 3/8 socket. It's wild how good a condition the CRV is with 318,000 miles, right? Where's Walker? There he is. Walker is a drifter, has a 8086 Toyota, but then his daily is this awesome CRV. So we can see it's pouring out. Factory service manual tells us that if the fluid is to the top or to the bottom of the fill plug, we know that it's full, right? So that's in, you know, it's pretty clean. It's actually not that bad. Walker mentioned that he had done it at some point, which is good. And so now we're gonna empty it. We're gonna get the drain plug off. It's doing the shimmy shake there. Oh boy, here we go.
All of the fluid.
One of the key issues with the DPSF is that as it nears its end of life cycle, it can cause chattering while cornering. It's not so much that it gets dirty, but if periodical oil changes aren't performed, it can cause much larger components to fail. You were mentioning the other day that you were driving this thing in the snow and you felt the front wheel slipping and it just sent power straight to the back?
Yeah, it sends power right to the back when it does start feeling the front wheel slip.
Primarily it's front wheel drive, and when you need it, it becomes all-wheel drive.
The reason for that is it gives way better fuel mileage while you're normal driving, and then when you actually need the system, it's there. Yesterday I pulled a 2007 Toyota Tacoma out of a ditch.
There you go.
And it only spun a little bit of tire.
The CRV that could, good stuff. The rear diff is fully drained. These are the old style washers, right? They're a little hard to find. So these are just like a flat aluminum washer, and we're replacing them with a crush washer, which is, I mean, the aluminum ones are also crush washers, but since we can't find those at our local parts store, we found M20 washers that are like a crush style. And then we're gonna fill it with this awesome stuff, Import DPS Fluid. The question is, what do we like to fill it with, right? Everyone has their own preferences. Some people pressurize bottles. This turkey baster looking gear filler is our current tool of choice. Let's see how much we can get in here. So both the drain and fill are 47 newton meters or 35 foot pounds. As far as torque spec goes, torque gauge go that low?
Just barely.
Just barely? You got it. All right, here we go. It's It's cool, we got the syringe on Amazon. It's been great because it actually shows you how much fluid you're putting in. So what do we got on there in there right now? Let's see, is it a whole quart? This is all in milliliters, super helpful. Sweet. Does the other side have standard stuff? No, it's all in metric. Fantastic. All right, let's go. Cool. This wide angle makes you look so artistic. Is that it? Is that the whole thing? Oh, a little bit left. A little bit. Yeah, it's definitely clearer than stuff that came out of it. All right, bottle number two. I'm pushing the hose up too so that, oh, there we go. There she is. And always it's better to do any kind of fluid change warm. Walker brought his car and obviously he drove it here. So we got the most amount of fluid out possible. Looks like we just did just over one quart. So 1.1 according to factory spec was definitely a pretty accurate measurement. 35 foot-pounds on the fill as well. Sweet. All right, man, good stuff. Every 30,000 miles, very, very simple maintenance. It's just drain and fill. Nothing too technical about it, really. It's an easy thing to do, but a lot of people forget about it. The front differential or the center differential is actually done with the transmission fluid. So when you do the transmission fluid, you've already handled the front, but the back, a lot of people forget about. Make sure you check it out. ENEOS Import DPS Fluid. Thank you for watching. Take it easy.